to present to you the speaker of the hour. Amen, amen. Well able, well able. Amen. Got that word down on the inside. Amen. Got experience honestly going through testing trials. Amen. Hallelujah. No, God is able to bring you out. Amen. If you ever go into a doctor getting some heart surgery and the doctor said, well, this is my first year, you be like, whoop. Hallelujah. You want somebody with some experience. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Somebody that could tell you something about Jesus.
Yes.
Amen. And not only tell you something about him, but live in the light. Amen. Isn't that worth something?
Yes.
Hallelujah. That's what Jesus did. He taught and then he gave example. That's what made him powerful. Amen. Hallelujah. So let us stand to our feet. Hallelujah. And let us receive, thank you, Lord, our associate pastor. Amen. The person of Pastor Elois.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
You may be seated in the
presence.
Amen. I sat there and I enjoyed every testimony, especially Sister Claudia's. Amen. My soul rejoiced in that testimony. Beautiful. Amen.
Amen.
You know, I was sitting there thinking, my son and I had a conversation this summer, the summer that his dad passed. And he was telling me, because his dad left him a nice car with low mileage, he said, Mom, this is my most prized possession. And I thought, I looked at him and I said, it is? I said, Jesus is my most proud. I said, Jesus is the best thing that ever happened to me. He's my most prized possession. If I lose him, I done lost
everything.
Amen? If you lose that car, you can get another car. But if you lose Jesus, he might not come back sometimes. Sometimes he'll come back too. Sometimes he won't. That's a chance you take. So you don't want to lose Jesus. Amen? Make him your number one priority. Amen.
Yeah.
He's your most prized possession. Amen.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Amen. I'm not going to be up here before you long. Amen. It's just something about this basement, though. Amen.
Yeah.
I guess the closeness, or I don't know, the anointing was so heavy down here today. Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. I'd like to give honor to my pastor, district elder, Pastor Frankie L. Quinn, First Lady, Sister Tracy Quinn, and Evangelist Stephanie Arrington, amen?
Yeah.
Amen. I'd like to give thanks for all of you today, amen?
Oh, yes.
You didn't have to come to church today,
but
God gave you a mind to be here, amen?
Yeah.
And we're all thankful for that.
Yeah.
I'd like to invite your attention this morning to the book of 2 Corinthians, chapter 4. Amen. Everybody get up, start preaching your sermon. Amen. Pastor gave my thought away this morning. She started preaching the sermon. He said a few things. Amen. A few thoughts. Amen. Lord, put thoughts in your head and they just go. Amen.
Amen.
Going to start reading at verse 15. For all things are for your sakes.
Yes.
That the abundant grace might through the thanksgiving of many redound to the glory of God.
Yes.
For which cause we faint not, but though our outward man perish, yet the inward man is renewed day by day.
Yes.
For our light affliction, which is but for a moment, worketh for us a far more exceeding and eternal weight of glory.
Yes.
While we look not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen. For the things which are seen are temporal, but the things which are not seen are eternal. Father, we come before you in the mighty name of Jesus.
Yes,
ask you, Lord, that you'll let my spirit decrease.
Yes,
let yours increase, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Make preaching easy in the name of Jesus. Bless the hearers, Lord. Make them doers of your word. In Jesus' name.
Yes,
amen. Amen. And the thought that the Lord gave me was, it's a light thing.
It's a light thing.
It's a light thing. Amen. Amen. You know, sometimes you things that you pick up are so light you almost drop them. Amen.
Yes.
And then there are things that get so heavy that you can't hardly carry them. Amen.
Yes.
But the scripture. scripture lets us know that all the things that we go through are for our sakes.
Yes.
God sends it to us, sends it our way for our sakes. And then he describes them, Paul, the Apostle Paul said, it's just a light thing. Amen. It's a light affliction. Amen. Nothing that will hurt you, because God sees it coming your way and he sends a buffeter. Yeah. To buffet that thing so that you're able to go through it. Amen?
Amen. Amen.
So it's always has to be in your mind that it's a light thing.
Yeah.
And you know what? Only those that were sinners and bought by grace, amen, the grace of Jesus Christ, can realize that all things are working together for our good. Amen. Amen. And that it's for your sakes, amen?
Amen.
Nothing just happens in this world.
Come on.
Nothing happens just to happen, amen?
Yeah.
All things are working for your good.
Yeah.
It's a light thing, he said.
Yeah.
You have to have faith to believe that that thing that you're going through is a light thing, amen?
Amen. Amen.
If you don't believe God when he says it's just a little light affliction,
uh-huh,
you won't go through it believing that I can make it through this thing.
Yes,
that
so.
It is a light affliction.
Yeah.
But you have to believe with all that's in your being,
uh-huh,
that it's working for your good.
Yeah.
Look at what he said. He said, you're renewed. It's taken, things are taken away from you, and you're renewed in your spirit day by day.
Yeah.
All in because of this light affliction. Amen.
Yes, yes.
This light affliction is not working against you.
Uh-huh.
It's working for you.
Right.
But you can't see it sometimes because we're looking at things that we can see and not things that we can't see.
Yeah.
Amen. And the things that you can see are only temporary.
Temporary.
The things that you can't see are the most important things.
Yeah.
See, I've got heaven in my view.
Yeah.
I can't see it. I've never been there. But I've got heaven in my view.
Yeah.
And everything that I've gone through in these 42 years,
yeah,
they've been just little light afflictions.
Light afflictions.
Sometimes it felt like it was heavy.
Yeah.
Sometimes I felt like that old goat with all the sins on his back.
Yeah.
Going out in the wilderness.
Yeah.
But God said, it's a light thing, Lord.
Yeah.
Believe that it's a light thing.
Yeah.
And this light thing is working for your good.
Yeah.
I see why David said, the Lord is my shepherd.
Yeah.
I shall not want.
Yeah.
He maketh me to lie down.
Come on.
He restored my soul.
Yes. Yes.
Said, yea, though I walk through the valley and the shadow of death,
yes,
I'll fear no evil, for
yes,
thou art with me.
Yes.
My Lord and my staff,
yes,
they comfort me.
Yes,
then he said, surely.
Surely.
Not maybe. Surely.
Surely.
Goodness and mercy,
yes,
shall follow me all the days,
yes,
of my life.
Yes.
And I'll dwell in the house,
yes,
of the Lord forever.
Forever.
Why, David? Because of all the light things.
Yeah. All, the light.
All the light things that I would
preach.
Yeah. All the light things preach that God allowed me to go through.
Yeah.
You see, God allowed me to kill a bear. Then to kill
come
a lion.
Yeah.
God allowed me to slay Goliath.
Yeah.
That
on.
Was a light thing.
Yeah.
All these light things I went through so that the power of God can rest in my life.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
All the things you go through.
Yes.
Yes.
You go through.
All the things you go through.
Yes.
And so the power of God,
yes, Lord,
can rest in your life.
Yes, Lord.
It can't rest in your life if you never go in it through anything.
I know that.
He said, arm yourself to suffer.
Arm.
If you want to reign with me, you're going to suffer.
Yes. Suffer.
Yeah.
No,
yeah,
suffering, no crown.
Yeah.
It's come just on. A light thing.
Just yeah, a light thing.
You have to tell your mind that,
oh,
when you're going
on.
Through it,
yeah,
it's just a light thing.
That's a light thing.
God put me in it.
Yeah.
He's going to bring me out.
Yeah.
He's the only one that can bring
yeah,
you out.
Yeah.
Only one that yeah, can bring you out.
Yeah.
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 You have to remember that all things are working for your good.
All
he's concerned about your soul.
Yes. That's right.
He knows your mind.
Yeah.
He said, I know the plans that beginning. Yes, yes, yes. Oh, when you start out in the beginning,
yes.
Seems rough.
Yes, Lord.
Seems hard.
Yes, Lord.
But the way of a transgressor is hard. Yes. Not the way of the godly. The way of the transgressor is hard.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
But it seems hard to you sometimes.
Yes.
But you have to remind yourself, the Lord is my shield. Yes. The Lord is my buckler. He'll bring me out. The Lord is my light. Yes. He's my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Whom shall I be afraid?
Amen?
Just the little light things we go through.
Yes, God.
I'm reminded of Cain and Abel.
Yes, Lord.
Yes.
And Cain slew Abel.
Yes.
And Adam and Eve thought they had lost a son for good.
My Lord.
They went through a life thing.
Yes.
It was a life thing they went through, losing a son.
Yeah.
It's a life thing we go through when we lose loved ones.
Yeah.
Because it pleased God when we go through it with the right attitude.
That's right.
It pleased God to bruise Jesus.
Yes, sir.
I don't understand that, but it pleased him to bruise Jesus.
Yeah.
It was just a life thing to God.
Yeah.
Amen. So it pleases God when the saints of God go through things.
Yeah. Yes.
And he go through it in the right attitude.
Right attitude.
He said in everything gives thanks. Yeah. In everything gives thanks. For this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you.
Yeah.
Amen.
Some things we thank him for.
Yeah.
Other things we never say nothing.
My.
Thank you for the good.
Yeah.
Thank you for the bad.
Yes.
Thank you for the ugly.
Yeah.
But there's some ugly things coming out of our
life. It happens.
Amen. There's some ugly things that happen in our life.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
But you got to remember that Jesus said, it's just a light thing.
Yes.
Paul said, it's just a light thing.
Yes, Lord.
That you're going through. It's just a light thing.
Yes, Lord.
Nothing that should get you down and keep you down.
Yeah. That's right.
Amen.
My God, that's true.
Nothing that should keep you down.
That's true. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
God said, I am that I am.
Yeah.
Yes.
Come on now. I'm whatever you want me to be.
Whatever.
If you need me to be this, I'll be that for you.
I'll be that.
I'm whatever you want me to be.
Yeah.
But don't let that light thing take you away from me.
Yeah, my God.
Come on.
My God.
What you're going through is just a light thing.
Hallelujah.
Don't let it move you.
Yeah. Amen. Hallelujah.
Thank
you,
Lord.
Hey, hallelujah.
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 We think, oh, Lord, how many times I'm going to have to go through this?
My Lord.
Because if you didn't pass it the first time, you're going through it again.
That's right.
And it's going to be worse the second time.
That's right.
And if you don't go through it the second time, God's going to send it again.
He's going to send it again.
And if you don't go through it the third time, right, it's going to be even rougher the fourth time.
My Lord.
Until you say, Lord, I surrender.
I surrender.
It's just a life thing, Lord. I surrender.
Hallelujah.
I'm going to let you have it, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Until you surrender to it, it won't be a light thing.
Yes.
But you'll know it's a light thing.
Yes, Lord.
You say, Pastor Duck, how can it be light when this thing I'm going through is heavy?
Come on.
My Lord.
It's light because I'm comparing it to eternity.
Yes. My Lord. That's right.
Eternity is forever. I hear him say, you're going to either be in the smoking section or the non-smoking section. It's a light thing compared to eternity.
Yes.
Hallelujah. On the day of Pentecost, they were all sitting there waiting.
Waiting
for their blessing. Amen.
Yeah,
they had been in Bethany, but the blessing wasn't there.
Uh-huh.
And they told them to go on to Jerusalem. So you'd be endued with power from on high.
Yeah.
And they were all sitting there, amen, waiting on the Lord.
Waiting on the Lord.
Waiting on the Lord. See, sometimes you have to be in the right place at the right time for your life thing to be delivered from. You have to be in the right place at the right time if you want deliverance.
Yes.
They were all sitting there.
Yes, Lord.
No doubt they all had their minds on Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Come on.
And all of a sudden, there that wind coming in.
Yeah.
I told you that the Lord moves in winds.
Yeah.
Ah, they were sitting there, and that the Holy Ghost came in like a rushing mighty wind.
Yeah.
And it got on each one of them. Tongue and tongues of fire.
Hey.
And they all started to speak in tongues. So if you have a light thing today that you can't seem to get rid of,
yes, Lord.
All you have to do is wait on the wind.
Wait on the wind.
Wait on the presence of the Lord. Wait on the moving of the wind.
Yeah.
And after a while, it'll be all
over.
It'll
be all over.
It'll be all over.
Yeah.
It's just a light thing.
Yes, Lord.
Just a light thing.
Yes, God.
These last 3 years of my life.
Come on.
In holiness.
Yes.
All those other life things I went through, I thought, oh, that ain't nothing. I said, Lord, I done been through everything a poor black woman could go through.
Jesus, come on now.
I said, I don't know what else you can do.
Yes.
Or send my way for me to show you that I love you.
Yeah, come on now.
I said, what else can come my way?
Thank you.
Lord took my husband.
Thank you, Jesus.
Come on, come on.
Then he took my sister 8 months later.
Come on, come on now.
And I thought, Lord Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
I thought I had went through everything
thank you, Jesus.
That could hurt me so bad.
Thank you, Jesus.
But you know what? When I realized whose I was, didn't God give his only begotten son?
Yeah.
He gave up Jesus so that I would not have to be in that fire.
Yeah.
Jesus took my place, your place, so we could go through these light afflictions.
Yeah. Follow
all the days of your life.
Yes.
Because we're never alone.
Yeah.
And it's just a light thing.
Yes, Lord.
Just a light thing that you're going through.
Yes, Lord.
After a while, you'll go through it and you'll look back and say, I had the victory over there. But you get that Holy Ghost, and Jesus can help you overcome all those light things. Amen?
That's right.
All those light afflictions in your life, the Lord will move them.
Yes, he will.
If he don't change you, he'll change the light things for you.
Amen.
That's it.
But you got to come to Jesus.
Amen.
There's no other way.
No other way.
To get to God, but through his dear son, Jesus Christ.
That's it.
You've got to come to Jesus.
Got to.
Is there one here today that has a lot of light things in their lives? And you know you're not doing them right. They seem heavy. And they seem heavy because of sin. Sin makes things heavy. But you don't have to keep sin in your life. You come to the Lord, and he works everything out all right. If any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. All old things are passed away, and everything has become new.